Hey guys, how y'all doing today? Here it is, another beautiful morning in the state of Florida. Aren't you so glad you live here? I know it's just a little bit moist outside, a little moisture in the air, a little bit of fog. But anyhow, it's going to be a great day. It's going to be a great day to come to the house of God. I hope I can challenge you. We're going to have a good time. And I'm going to tell you something. It's going to be a message that's going to be good for your family to hear tonight. We're going to be talking on the subject of, how should I describe it? I haven't got a title yet for it, but talking about the things that we like to avoid, okay? I think one of the things that we do in life is we avoid issues, but that's not for right now. Right now, we have finished the book of James, and we're just kind of bouncing around different scriptures that the Lord might lead us to. This morning, I'd like for you to think about 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. Heather, put them on the screens here for me. And I just want this to sink in for just a little bit. I don't know how it is around your house, but around our house, Miss Sherry is the recycle queen. Everything that can possibly be recycled goes into the recycle bin. So now for us who take out the trash twice a week or whatever we have to do, now we have two trash cans in the house, okay? And now we have the one in the kitchen that has all the, you know, the coffee grinds, the food and all that kind of stuff goes into it. And then over by our utility room, we have what she calls the recycle, okay? She's into the recycle. And she likes that big blue recycle bin that the county gives us, and we fill it up each week. We take it out every Wednesday night after church. I got to take out the garbage Wednesday nights and Sunday nights right after church. Both of them go out on Wednesday nights, and so that's what we do around our house. Recycling, as I'm finding out and understanding, is extremely important and is profitable. There's a lot of things in our society that gets recycled, from cars, batteries, boxes, styrofoam, you wouldn't believe it. Christmas trees get recycled into mulch, and just on and on and on. People have discovered ways to take an object that is no more useful and begin to make something out of it. And I'm reminded that the airport there at LaGuardia, New York, is made on a hill that that at one time was a trash heap of the city of New York. So when you land in the Big Apple now, just think you're landing in there on that old pile of refuse. I'm thinking, you know, baggages of all kinds of garbage mounted up onto this mountain, and they've come in, these engineers have come in, and they've known how to do it and compact it and press it and use it so they can land those 747s on there. It's quite powerful when you think about it, what all happens. You know, I think sometimes when we think about recycling, we got to realize that God does the same thing in our lives. He recycles. He takes the worst things that can happen to us. Like, and it's not just our sinful things that get us into trouble, but the things that happen in our lives. And I'm going to tell you something. There's been a lot of people who've walked through some valleys. There's been people who've had to witness death firsthand, maybe in the family or maybe even in a situation where they saw somebody die. And, you know, God can take those things and recycle them in our lives and use them for His glory. It's an absolutely amazing thing. You know, sometimes maybe we as preachers have said different things like this, you know, let it go, you know. Let's just take, for an example, a husband steps out on a wife, okay, goes and does that which is wrong, hurts his wife, hurts his family, hurts his kids, hurts his testimony, hurts everything. Well, what is a wife to do? You know, sometimes we preach and preach and we preach, well, you got to forgive, and, you know, you got to let some of those hurts go. Maybe instead of saying the words, let it go, maybe we should say the words, surrender it. Surrender it. Why, it seems like all through the Bible, those who surrendered their shortcomings, their weaknesses, their past, their, let's just use it, garbage bags to the Lord, God turned them around and used them. And the Apostle Paul undoubtedly is one of the great examples how that his life, man, he thought he was doing good things as he persecuted the Christians. And as he realized how wrong it was once he met Jesus Christ, realized that he had to surrender the baggage to the Lord so the Lord could use it. Here's the verse I was thinking about. Look what it says here in 2 Corinthians chapter number 1. Blessed be God. Wow, that right there is a mouthful. Praise, worship, blessed be God. Let's bless Him. Even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. Listen, let God comfort you in those times where we sinned, where we felt useless, where our lives went through valleys, sometimes not of our own. You know, I'm thinking of a family that's going through a valley right now that's just really dark. They don't, you know, but I know that eventually one day we're going to get to the place where God will recycle this if it's surrendered to Him. And that's what's important. But He says, let God be the God of all comfort. And, you know, I'm going to tell you something, and that speaks volumes to those of you who want to be comfort people. Hey, listen, you need to be used of God, okay? Comforting is not finding out about, you know, everything involved in the situation. Comforting there is allowing God to love through you. And sometimes I think we get things backwards. We think that we are the comforters. No, God comforts through us, and because He is the God of all comfort. But look what it says in verse number 4. Who comforts us in all our tribulations. And that tribulation is not just a sin that we do that gives us the headache. That tribulation are all of life's trials, all of it mixed in together. And see, we come through these things, and God uses these things as He recycles them into our life. Because here's the next part of this verse. This is the recycling part. Look at this. That we may be able to comfort them which are in trouble. All right, comforters, now you're not just going in to get the scoop. Now you're going in because of how that God has recycled your life through the trials and the things that you've been through, that you can now be a comfort, a help, a blessing to those who are in trouble. And then look what he says, by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. In other words, once God has come along in your trial and your situation and He has worked in your life, why, you surrender those trials that you now have, that you may now go and be a comfort to somebody else. And how important that is in our lives, and not only in our lives, but in the lives of those that we love. You know, really, we are recycled people because every one of us have tribulations of sorts. Right? Some of us have relationship tribulations. Some of us have financial tribulations. Some of us, well, we have that besetting sin, that addicting sin that just comes and it just seems as though it's grabbed hold of our life and will not let us go. And we have to surrender it all to the cause of Christ. I really believe Paul's saying, listen, this is what real Christianity is all about, is yes, becoming a comforter, because you know what? You have the comforter living inside you. And surrender everything that comes into your life to Him, that He may use it in a way that'll bring honor and glory to the Lord Jesus Christ. It's a powerful thing when God's people come to the place where they realize that, hey, these things that I've gone through in my life, now I understand. I'm going to tell you something. You can't experience the sting of being cheated on this week and think you're going to be a comforter next week. I realize it's through time. It's through a relationship with Christ and walking with Him day by day that God transforms those things immediately into something that is useful for those around you. But what I'm saying is learn to surrender daily those things to the Lord Jesus Christ, that He may use you to be a comforter to those around Him, around you rather. All right, God bless you. And let's be in God's house tonight for some lasagna, okay? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, once again, we thank You for, Lord, we thank You for those in our lives that are such comforters. People who have been through some deep, dark valleys, who with Your mercy, with Your grace, they have surrendered their hurt, their pain, their tribulation, Father, to You. And Lord, You've made comforters out of them. Father, we pray, Lord, that You teach us to surrender the baggage, Lord, that we too can be recycled into a position where we can be used for Your glory. Father, thank you for these wonderful people. I pray you bless them today. Give them a good day. Be with us tonight in the house, Father, that we may serve and worship you. And Lord, just have a great service in your name. For we pray in Christ's name. Amen. Amen. All right. Go serve your King. Bye-bye.